Hello students, in this video we are going to study some of the conventional methods that are used for tunneling. So first method is a drill and blast method. It is mainly used for the hard rock where digging is not possible. This was very common before the development of the TBM, that is the tunnel boring machine. This drill and blast method process tends to have a lower capital cost than the use of TBM, but this method is slower. So this is how the drilling and the blasting process is done. First, the drilling is done, then loading. What is loaded? Some of the explosives are being loaded into the holes, then they are blasted. A ventilation purpose, some of the pipes are being provided, then the mucking is done, that is dislodging, then scaling is done, lining, bolting, and then the survey is done whether the process is being done properly or not. This is how the drill and blast method works. Next is the drill rod header. These are the track mounted excavating machines that have powerful cutting booms. These were commonly used in the coal mining or in the civil engineering constructions works that requires a range of tunnel diameters. These are relatively flexible and can be fitted with extra equipment such as gathering arms, water jets, and the conveyors. So what are the water jets used for? To reduce the dust, and the conveyors are used for removing the debris. So this is a rod header. Open and cut method. This method was suitable for shallow tunnels. It involves the construction of an open trench within which the tunnel is constructed, and then the trench is backfilled. So depending on the ground conditions, the side walls may be constructed before the trench is created or after. Again, it involves creating the roof slab of a tunnel first and then the shallow trench. The trench can then be backfilled and the tunnel constructed underneath the cover. The advantage of cut and cover method is that it releases the site above the tunnel for other uses. So this is a cut and cover method. Immersed tube method. This method is suitable for tunnels that cross deep waters. These are the prefabricated sections of either concrete or steel tunnel which are lowered into prepared trench at the sea or the riverbed level. Here the trench is backfilled and any necessary protection construction above. This is a immersed tube construction method. Pipe jacking method. It is a trenchless technology. In this, a drive pit is constructed and then sections of steel or concrete tube are hydraulically jacked forward from the pit to form a tunnel lining. It is suitable for installing services under the canals, railway embankments, and roads where it is important that there is little or no disturbance. It is preferred because of its simplicity and because it avoids the settlement of the ground. So this is the process of pipe jacking method. Box jacking method. It is similar to pipe jacking, but a box shaped section is jacked forward rather than the pipe. It can allow a larger tunnel to be created. This is how a box tunnel is done. Auger boring method. It is a non-steerable rotating cutting head used mainly for conduit installation. A rail mounted machine augers the soil as it pushes a sleeve or a tube into the ground. The auger cuts the face of the borehole as it turns, transporting the excavated spoil back down the sleeve into the shaft. Then a length of the sleeve is inserted by the machine, which then withdraws to have another length of sleeve welded on, and the auger flight is being extended. This process is repeated till the boring process is done. Thank you.